from the dead. We'll give you new life to our own mortal bodies through His Spirit living in us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, praise the Lord. Connect ourselves to God today. When you are able to pray, you should be able to connect to God. If you're not able to connect yourselves to God, that means my prayer is a waste. Jeremiah chapter 33:3 will say, you shall call me and I shall answer you. You're all reflecting on the fruits of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit cannot give us anything, absolutely anything, if you're not able to connect yourselves to God. The Spirit of the Lord will work only when we stay humble ourselves and bend before Him and pray. The angel Gabriel says to Mary, hail full of grace, the Lord is with you. And the same angel will say to Mary, the Holy Spirit will overshadow you. Overshadow you, Holy Spirit. Overshadow you. When the apostles and Mary, sitting in the top room and praying on the day of the Pentecost, once again, the Spirit of the Lord is overshadowing them. That is a power, in fact. You see the difference once they receive the power of the Holy Spirit overshadowing them on the day of the Pentecost. A people who are timid, fearful, those people who ran away, are speaking to the world today, and that time, I am ready to give my life for the sake of Christ, because you have crucified Him, and today I will stand to the witness of Him who has called me. He says, with the power of the Holy Spirit. That is the power of the strength. You know, sometimes, you know, we enter into the prayer room like a gloomy face. We also go out in a gloomy face only. What Spirit of the Lord will work for us? You see? I enter as I am and I'm going out also as I am. Maybe what is the first fruit there? Self-control. Ah, that you got now. What is the second fruit there? Faithfulness. Be faithful to God and be faithful to your own people in your family. What is the third fruit there? Gentleness. See, that is very important. Not roughness like me. No. Jesus says, those who humble yourself will be exalted. Praise the Lord. What is the fourth one? Patience. See, if you don't be patient, you'll be patient. You know that? We all need to learn to be, you know, patience we should have everybody. What is the next one? Peace. Shanti. Now, peace is given by Spirit, yes. But Jesus gives you the full of peace. You see, after the resurrection, no, Jesus says, I give you my peace. I shall leave you my peace. Those who believe, Jesus will give you today. I tell you, my dear brothers and sisters. Believe. And that is the only shortcut that you can now to meet God. That's the only shortcut. What is the next one?
Love,
this is very important. John 3:16 will say, God so loved the world that He gave His only Son as a ransom for many. God so loved the world. What is the next one?
Joy.
Very important. How many of us are really joyful, you say to me? How many of us are satisfied in life? What is this joy actually? Angels will bring the joyful news for the shepherds. Says, glory to God in the highest and peace to His people on His earth. And we should be joyful in every situation possible. Every situation possible. Be joyful first and ask for the more joy from the Lord and He will give you. Are you joyful now?
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Next one.
Goodness.
Goodness. goodness, my goodness. Only goodness, my goodness. Goodness cannot be acted out. Be good. Don't act. Should never act. But be good in your own self. And that is the fruit of the Holy Spirit. But how many of us express ourselves really in good, you know, goodness in us? And that's the reason I told you in the beginning. When we speak of, you know, goodness and so on like that, when you are able to connect God in the way that Spirit of the Lord wants, not the way that I want. You see, the last one is what? What? Kind. Be kind. I do not know how to be kind. I do not know. Most of us do not know how to be kind enough. Kindness is something that, you know, all the other fruits of the Holy Spirit are combined, everything has to make a person a kind, like a sponge. A sponge that absorbs everything, not like a rock that does not sink anything. As we are participating in this Holy Eucharist, let us believe that God is with us. Believe. God will be with us. Emmanuel. God is with us. Praise the Lord. Let's bend our heads for moments. All of us. Let's bend our heads before the Lord and pray. Jesus, today I ask you pardon. I ask your mercy. Forgive all my faults, all my shortcomings. I am a human being, stumbling most of the times. I want to be with you, but so many powers will be blocking me that I am not able to come to you, my Lord. Come to you, my Lord. There are so many things blocks me. I'm not able to come to you. I'm a human being. Bless me. I have so many shortcomings. Bless me. Today you transform me, Jesus. I submit with all my faults, with all my goodness, I submit to you. This is who I am. I am the open book before you, Jesus. May the Jesus was called us today to participate in this Holy Eucharist will be accepting us as we are, open book. Irrespective of whether good or not, Jesus will be able to accept us today, my dear brothers and sisters, so that Jesus washing our sins, today we all partake in the Holy Eucharist in a worthy way. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words,
in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault,
therefore I ask
Blessed Mary, your Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Lord, have mercy on your servants gathered here. Lord, have mercy on your servants gathered here. We confess we have sinned in thought and words and deeds. Lord,
let us pray. God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power of Christ conquered death and you returned to you in glory, may all your people who have gone before us in faith share his victory and enjoy the vision of your glory forever. We ask it through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. I, John,
angel ascend from the rising of the sun with the seal of the living God, and he called with a loud voice to the four angels who had been given power to harm earth and sea, saying, "Do not harm the earth or the sea or the trees till we have sealed the servants of our God upon their foreheads." And I heard the number of the sealed, 144,000 sealed, out of every tribe of the sons of Israel. After this, I looked, and behold, a great multitude, which no man could number, from every nation, from all tribes and people and tongues, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, clothed in white robes, with palm branches in their hands, and crying out with a loud voice, "Salvation belongs to our God, who sits upon the throne, and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood round the throne, and round the elders, and the four living creatures. And they fell on their faces before the throne, and worshiped God, saying, "Amen. Blessings and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these clothed in white robes, and whence have they come?" I said to him, "Sir, you know." And he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great tribulation. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb." The word of the Lord.
Filled with wonder, awestruck wonder at the mention of your name. Filled with wonder, awestruck wonder at the mention of your name. Jesus, your name is
love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God. And so we are. The reason why the world does not know us is that it did not know Him. Beloved, we are God's children now. It does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when He appears, we shall be like Him, for we shall see Him as He is. And everyone who thus hopes in His purifies himself as He is pure. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand for gospel acclamation.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah, hallelujah, by the blood of Christ we stand. Every tongue, every tribe, every people, every land, giving glory, giving honor, giving praise unto the Lamb of God.
The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke's Gospel, chapter 18, verses 9 to 14. He also told this parable to some who trusted in themselves, that they were righteous and regarded others as contempt. Two men went up to the temple to pray, one Pharisee and the other a tax collector. The Pharisee, standing by himself, was praying thus, God, I thank you that I am not like other people, thieves, rogues, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. I fast twice a week. I give a tenth of all my income. But the tax collector, standing far off, would not even look up to heaven, but was beating his breast and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you this, the man who went down to his home justified rather than the other, for all who exalt themselves will be humbled, but all who humble themselves will be exalted. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I have prayed and I am convinced. A doctor went to the church and stood before the altar here, and he raised his hand and praying to God, he says, Jesus the Redeemer, you are everything. I love you, simply I love you. Jesus, you have made me MBBS. I am a doctor. You know that? I am a doctor. As you are able to heal the patients, I am also able to heal the patients out of medicine. You give free of cost, but I will give you out of money. That is only difference, Jesus. But today I am here to pray. I am here to pray today. I am a doctor. I have built an hospital. I have built an hospital. Jesus, as I am your believer, I strongly believe in it. See that there are more and more and more and more and more patients to my hospital. That means God has to send more patients to his hospital. How sad. How sad. The same hospital, a nurse came to pray after the doctor to the same place. Jesus, you have said to me, I have read the Bible clearly, all those who are burdened, heavy hearted, come to me, I shall give you peace of mind. You have told me, that is the reason I have come here today. You are sending more patients to my hospital. You know how hard I am struggling from morning till evening? I am exhausted, Jesus. I am exhausted. If you believe that I am your favorite daughter, my Jesus, you are my Jesus. I love you. See that no patient is coming to the hospital. A same hospital, a patient came to Jesus. standing here and praying, Jesus, I have read the Bible thoroughly. I have read New Testament, may not be Old Testament, New Testament I have read thoroughly. I have read thorough. I know that you healed so many people, those who asked you, and you have said, I know, you have said somewhere in the Bible, you have no, I know you have said, what is said? Ask, it will be given to you. Knock, the door will be opened. Seek, and you will find it. See, you asked me now. I am asking you now. I am knocking you now. I am seeking you now. Jesus, take away all my sickness from me, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, Jesus. You are going to take away my sicknesses. To the same place, a robber came and prayed. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. I know. There were two robbers were put on your left and right. You know that, no? I know. I have read in the Bible. No. I am a Catholic, you know. I have read in the Bible. I know. Jesus, I know. What is said? One is at your right hand and one is at your left hand. I know. I know, I know, I know, I know. But Jesus, you have protected the right hand robber. You said, today you shall be with me in the paradise. Ah, how nice, no? Today you shall be with me, paradise. And the robber said, today, not today, all the days I have been robbing. Tomorrow also I am going to rob. And since I know that you are a protector, I know, you send your Holy Spirit only once tomorrow, afterwards I will stop robbing. Only tomorrow, send your Holy Spirit and some angels to protect me. See that nobody sees me except you, Jesus. Because I know wherever I am, you will see me. But human being, no. Only I should drop. He prayed and he went. A teacher is coming to the same place and praying. Jesus, I am tired of now teaching, Jesus. And this modern world children, you know, I am tired, Jesus. See that, at least, if you have a little concern for me, that no student should ask a question in the classroom. Concern, little concern. Nobody should ask a question. Then the student coming and praying in the same place. Jesus, I know, I have read in the Bible, allow the small children towards me because they are like angels in heaven, ascending and descending. And you said, they shall come to me, I shall bless them. I have come to you, Jesus, today I have come to you. Bless me immensely. What is the blessing he is asking? Jesus, I am going to the school every day. My father also is beating me and sending to the school. My mummy is another kind of father. More ferocious than my father. Always scolding me and sending to the school, Jesus. And my teacher also scolds me. How many days should I bear with these things? See that there should be a little shake in Bangalore. What is that little shake? What is that? Earthquake. So that at least my school should be down. At least my school should be down. He prays. Is God confused with his prayers? Tell me, my dear brothers and sisters. Is God confused with these prayers? Yes or no? Not confused. My goodness, my goodness, my goodness. God is confused. Whom to bless? And if he says child should be blessed, means school will come down. You see? If you want to bless the robber, means somebody's house will go. All the wealth will go.
If he blesses the doctor means finished. He has to make all patients and send to him. You see? And if he blesses the nurse means no patient will be there. And if he is blessing the patient means no sickness at all, then where is the doctor? To whom shall he bless? To whom shall he bless? How shall I pray that God may hear me? To whom shall I bless? God is totally and fully like examination is confused. My dear brothers, I say to you today, those who pray with a selfish heart, selfishness, you shall not be blessed. There shall not be a selfishness in you. You pray for your needs. Good. Pray only what is needed. Only what is needed. In the gospel today, we saw the Pharisee and tax collector is going into the church or a temple those days. What is praying? I praise you, Lord, for everything that you have been to me. How wonderful you are. Life is beautiful. Make it wonderful. And you have made it me like that. I am really grateful to you. Praise you, Lord. And he says. At the same time, the Pharisee says, I am not a thief. I am not an adulterer myself. Like this fellow. But another man is praying in the gospel today. He's beating his, what is beating? His breast, his heart is beating. He's bending his head and praying. God, I am a sinner. God, I am a sinner. Bless me. But Jesus says, those who went home happily and content with the blessings of one, is the one and only one, the tax collector. The Pharisee is praying every day. Twice a week he is fasting. Remember, twice a week he is fasting. Every month he is giving 1/10 of his salary to the temple. But still God did not bless him. See, fasting, no? How many of us fast? How many of us pray? For whom are you fasting? For whom are you giving the alms and ammunition? To God. Very nice. To God. Fast. Good. Give alms and ammunition. Good. But let us be very clear, my dear brothers, today. When you are able to give, when you are able to fast, fast. Good. But the question mark is, how do you fast? Sometimes before us you will enter into the kingdom of God. But Jesus says, all those who call me Lord, 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 Lord will not enter into the kingdom of God. But Jesus says, when you pray, my dear brothers and sisters, when you pray, submit yourself to God. Submit. Surrender. When you pray, bend your head and pray. When Solomon went to God, he knelt and prayed. Remember, he knelt and prayed. And his both hands were towards the heaven. And he is kneeling and praying. Solomon the king is praying. At the same time, the Daniel is praying every day, kneeling and praying to God. Daniel chapter 6. Verse 10, he kneels and prays. Daniel. Jesus knelt in the, where? Are you sure that he knelt in Gethsemane? Are you sure? I am not sure. Are you sure? Yes or no? Because you were convinced, I am also convinced that Jesus knelt in the Gethsemane and prayed. If you are not convinced, I am also not convinced. He knelt and prayed. before he was getting arrested. Who? Jesus. Peter, he knelt and prayed. Peter, that gentleman is very, very pickle-minded man. Peter, Saint Peter, very, very pickle mind. He says, when Jesus called him, no, he says, Jesus, I am sinner, go away from me. Don't come to me, go. But Jesus will say once to him, "Hey, Satan, go away from me." But Jesus will now ask him, "Peter, Peter, 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 do you love me more than everybody else? Peter, do you love me? Peter, do you love me?" He says, "Jesus, more than I know, you know everything that I love you. Are fellow, when you are young, you know, you used to go wherever you want to go. But there is a time coming. Feed my sheep." What he says? Feed my sheep. When Abraham is praying for the Lot's family, he is praying to God, "God, are you going to destroy this Lot's family? I am praying, please God, don't do." Prayer can change the situations. Prayer can. And prayer protected the Lord's family, and God did not destroy. When Ezekiel prayed for the enemies to be destroyed, God heard. And he destroyed more than 185,000 of army of others. Prayed. When Israel prayed for the people to get converted, prayers can melt the hearts of the others. Prayers can melt. Whatever happens, whatever goes, what comes in and goes out is not important. But the way I pray before God is very, very important. Don't take God lightly. Don't take God loosely. Don't take God like an emergency ward for a treatment. Don't take God like that. If you are able to take God in that way, then God also will treat you in emergency way only. I tell you, don't treat God like an emergency ward. We shall not meet like that God, but we should have our own time to meet him. I know you are all tired. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. And the power and the Holy Spirit will be with you always, every time. May God bless you always. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We offer you, O Lord,
brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice from your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Lord, in your kindness, accept these gifts for our departed brothers and sisters, and for all who sleep in Christ. May his perfect sacrifice free them from the power of death, and give them the eternal life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, all-powerful and ever-living God, who will always and everywhere to give you thanks, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Today we keep the festival of your holy city, the heavenly Jerusalem for our mother around your throne. The saints, our brothers and sisters, sing your praise forever. Their glory fills us with joy and they come in with us in your church. Give us inspiration and strength as we ascend our pilgrimage of faith, eager to meet you then. With their great company and all the angels, we praise your glory as we cry out without with one voice.
Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the
Zena.